Dear all, welcome to my YouTube channel, and today we are going to discuss our topic, that is application layer. Before that, we have discussed about the OSI model. If I talk about the application layer, this is the first layer of the OSI model, and it is the topmost layer of the OSI model. Okay, and it is responsible for providing the end users or application a user interface or generating the data over the networks by using a browser or any application. Basically, there are a number of protocols that works on the application layer. The first protocol is hypertext transfer protocol. This is called HTTP protocol. Here, this protocol is responsible for transferring the HTTP request in between website and a server, web browser and server. Basically, if I want to open a website, that is facebook.com, how I can open this website? An HTTP request will be generated from my PC to the server by the help of internet. This request will be forwarded to the server. In response of that, the server will forward a response. And the port number of this protocol, the HTTP protocol, is 80 basically. But the problem with the HTTP protocol is that all the data will be forwarded in form of plain text basically. So anyone in over the node, over the internet, can track your data basically. This is the main issue with HTTP protocol. That is why we have introduced the HTTPS protocol. So HTTPS protocol is the secured version of the HTTP protocol. This protocol is doing the encryption and decryption by using the SSL certificate basically. So this is my PC. I'm using a banking website on which I have login credential of my banking, like username Ritik123 or password and so on, right? So, and by the help of encryption, the data will be converted into another format, like username is converted into this format and password is converted into any other format, right? So this is how the encryption will be done in HTTPS protocol. In response of that, the data will also be forwarded in encrypted format. That is means no one can track your data over the internet basically. This is the process is called encryption and decryption. And this is done by the help of an SSL certificate that is provided by number of companies over the internet. Let us assume, let's talk about the google.com. So just if you want to check that the website is secured or not, just click on this icon. Whenever you will click the icon, it is showing connection is secured, right? Then again, click here, it is showing certificate is valid. That is means your SSL encryption is working properly. Okay. Now, this is the type of encryption, SHA 256, SHA 1 fingerprint. So Google is using these fingerprints. And okay. So our next protocol is file transfer protocol. Basically, this protocol enables you to upload, download, delete or rename your data over the remote servers basically. So this is your PC from which you want to upload or download the data. So first of all, you have to log in your device, okay, log in your website and navigating the directory. So all of these process done by the control channel in which you that session will be terminated, session will be initiated. And these kind of process will be done on what? On the control channel, right? And the data channel is used to upload or download the files over the FTP servers or the remote servers, basically. Now, our next protocol is SMTP protocol. Which one? SMTP protocol and POP, post office protocol. Okay, these two protocols are used to forward or receive the mail email on your mail servers basically. If you want to forward the messages between your PC and mail server, so it could be possible by the help of what? SMTP protocol. By the help of SMTP protocol, you can forward the data, the emails, to the nearest mail server. Okay, and by the help of POP, you can retrieve the emails that are uploaded over the received over the mail server. So that could be possible by the help of what? POP protocol. Okay, and it is basically used to download the emails from your mail server. Now Our next protocol is what? IMAP protocol. Dear, let us assume you have number of email that is already received by your email servers. And these email can be opened by your PC, by your tablet, or by your laptop, or by your smartphone. So that is means multiple devices could able to access the email, upload it over the mail server. And that can be possible by the help of what? IMAP protocol, IMAP protocol. Internet Message Access Protocol is used to access these emails basically. Okay. Next protocol is what? Next is domain name system. So dear all the server basically has an IP address. What? All the servers over the internet has a specific IP address. Whenever you will put a domain name in your browser like https://example.com, the DNS server will convert this domain into the IP address. After converting this to IP address, your browser will request to this the nearest server that is having this IP address. In response of that, the web page will be forwarded, right? So that is means DNS server is used to allocate the IP address for the domain name system, for the domain name basically. Okay, next is what? SNMP protocol, that is also known as Simple Network Management Protocol. It is used to manage and monitor the networking devices by the help of what? Monitoring server. So this is my SNMP manager who can remotely access all of these devices like switch, router, or server remotely from a location by the help of what? SNMP protocol. Okay. Now, next one is Telnet. Basically, if I want to remotely access my server, that could be possible by the help of Telnet. I can remotely access the server without physically present at the device. The problem with the Telnet is that the Telnet works in plain text and the SSH works over the encrypted text basically. Now, our next protocol is DHCP protocol, that is also known as Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. Here, this protocol basically assigns the IP addresses and network IP addresses to the client. Let us assume this is my client, which need an IP address dynamically. So this IP address can be dynamically allocated by the help of a DHCP server. So here we have a DHCP server which will provide the IP addresses, which has responsibility to provide the IP addresses basically. So here, first of all, your PC will generate a request or will forward. First of all, your PC will generate a request for the IP address dynamically. In response of that, the PC will forward the DHCP server discovery messages. By the help of this message, the PC will forward the DHCP message to the server. In response of that, the nearest DHCP server will forward a reply message. Yes, I am available and I have this IP address for you. In response of that, the PC will request that IP address, and in response of that, an acknowledgement will be forwarded that you can have this IP address. So this is four step of process. We are going to deeply study about this DHCP process in our upcoming classes. So don't be worry about it. We have a lot more to study.